I've sent some messages I'm not proud of, made some phone calls no one wants to admit to, and blindly committed myself saying, I love you. My parents couldn't know, how would they react if they knew the words behind that keyboard tap? But in all reality, who even cared? They were too busy arguing to see who listened to what I had to share. It was a man I had met in a chat room, 2 years under 22, and over the course of 9 months, it was only him I had pursued. He was a Christian and a nice guy, but who knew what came in the form of good could be the cause of so many lies? So every day was the same routine, texting from 8 a.m. to 2, and it wasn't until my mom read our messages that anyone had a clue. She notified the police, and I didn't understand how anyone could do this to what I thought was such a nice man. But later I found out that my thoughts weren't so true, and he wasn't the guy I thought I had been speaking to. His name may have matched his face, and hurting me wasn't in his plans, but he would never wait for me after our no contact order would end. So something finally clicked, and I knew what I had to do. I had to move on because I had a future to attend to. So after 6 months, I had an encounter with a friend whose brother had good intentions and wanted me to let him in. So I took the chance as he took the place, and he showed me that I was not alone in this race. He's held my hand this entire way through and accepted some pretty awful things that I've done too. But with that in the past, he's got me moving again towards a future more promising than some internet boyfriend. For someone who's never had a girlfriend, he's sure done a lot more than one should expect. He's taken the place of any male figure in my life and shown me all forms of respect. And for that, I don't know what to say except thank you. You've truly been a dream come true.